Good afternoon and happy feast day. Today is a special day for all of us here at the Ursuline School and for Ursuline schools around the world. Today we celebrate the remarkable life of St. Angela Merici, foundress of the Ursuline Sisters, who established our school in 1897. In the year 1535, St. Angela began a new way of life for the women of her time. In the 1500s, the only options women had were to either get married or to enter a convent and become a nun. St. Angela founded a group of women called the Company of St. Ursula. These women could dedicate their lives totally to God as they lived lives of prayer and service. They could continue to live in their own homes. This was a revolutionary move for her time. St. Angela's spirit is among us as she calls each of us to live lives of prayer and service, while at the same time being willing to take risks and try new things in our time. During our liturgy today, we will hear Angela's words imploring her companions to live in unity, united in one heart and one will. She urges her daughters to be bound to one another, helping each other and bearing with each other in Jesus Christ. She promises to be in their midst, lending aid to their prayers. So we ask St. Angela's intercession at this Mass. We all strive for this unity that will empower us to do all that pleases God in our own time. St. Angela does indeed watch over all of our days. Please stand and greet our celebrant, Monsignor Dennis Keane, and join in singing the hymn to St. Angela.
One God, ever and ever. A reading from the first letter of John. We declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked at and touched with our hands concerning the word of life. This life was revealed. We have seen it and testified to it, and declare to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaimed to you, that God is light and in him there is no darkness at all. The word of the Lord.
From St. Angelo's Last Counsel, my last word to you, by which I implore you, even with my blood, is that you live in harmony, united together, all with one heart and one will. Be bound to one another by the bond of charity, esteeming each other, helping each other, bearing with each other in Jesus Christ. For if you strive to be like this, without any doubt, the Lord God will be in your midst. You will have in your favor Our Lady, the apostles, all the saints, the angels, and finally, all heaven and all the universe. Because God has so ordained from all eternity that those who, for his honor, are united in doing good enjoy every prosperity, and that what they do turns out well, because they have God himself and every one of his creatures in their favor. See then how important is this union and concord. So, long for it, pursue it, embrace it, hold on to it with all your strength. For I tell you, living all together, thus united in heart, you will be like a mighty fortress, or a tower impregnable, and I shall always be in your midst, helping your prayers.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants anymore, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. I appointed you to go bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands, so that you may love one another. The Gospel of the Lord. There's so little daylight these days. It can get a little depressing at times. Wake up, it's dark, and by the time you get home from school, I'm sure it's dark. There's a lot of darkness, that physical darkness that really surrounds us, that we have to bear with a little bit longer. But there's other types of darkness too, besides that physical darkness that surrounds us as well. We have the darkness of the pandemic. All of us are wearing masks and we're staying separate from each other. We can't do what we normally do. Our routines are broken. It's a difficult time. And then there's the darkness on the spiritual side. The sin of racism. We saw it awfully portrayed this summer. In different protests, violence in our streets. Yes, there's a lot of darkness in the world. Physical and spiritual. But today we celebrate a woman of light, Angela. A woman who magnified the light of Christ in her life. She lived in difficult times. She lost both her parents when she was only 10 years of age. Can you imagine? The times were tough, and her own personal life was even tougher, because of the lack of love, that warm environment that enables you and me and all of us to grow and to flourish. She lived in difficult times as we do, but hopefully as we do, she was a woman of vision. She didn't let darkness block her view. She was able to see what could take place. She could dream of the future, hope for a better world. And she did that. She first found Christ in her own heart, and then attracted many others to her, so that together they may radiate that wonderful beauty, that light, that conquers darkness, that light that reminds us that we can always dream, we can always hope, we can always pray. No matter how bad a particular situation might be. Yes, St. Angela saw the very best in other people. And isn't that great? A great thing to say about anyone. They see the best. They see the goodness. They see the jewel of the individual. St. Angela did that. And perhaps that's one of the ways to make the world a brighter place, to see the best in each other. Too often we can put people down, too often we can say things negative, too often we can participate in gossip, we can do things that hurt us. St. Angela reminds us, and that's why we celebrate this feast day, to always see the best in one another. What a great gift that is. St. St. Angela, a woman of faith, a woman of hope, and a woman of love. Wouldn't it be great if it could be said of all of us that we are people of faith, people of hope, people of love? The Blessed Mother, one of her great prayers was the Magnificat. The prayer begins, "My soul rejoices in God, my Savior." Isn't that a wonderful thing? The joy that St. Angela had, the Blessed Mother had, that all of us could have in God, our Savior. And our task then is to be like a missionary, to share that brightness, to share that love with one another. So that's what we pray at Mass this day. We pray for everybody here, for everybody in the classrooms, for everyone at home. We pray that we can magnify the presence of God's light in our world, as St. Angela did so well. And I'd like to invite the girls who will be leading us in the prayer of the faithful to come forward. We come to you, Lord, with many concerns and intentions on our mind and in our hearts, and we ask you to hear us as we now pray. We thank you, Lord, for always hearing our prayers, confident in your constant care and unfailing love. We place our intentions in your hands and ask for continued grace as we make our prayer in the name of Jesus, who lives and reigns with you, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Blessed be one God of all creation, for your goodness we have this great and love. The church has given you human hands and may you come for us. Celebrate. work of our redemption is accomplished. In Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created human race, and when he was justly dead in mercy, you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, the blessed seraphim, worship together with thankful supplication. May our voices join with theirs in humble praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Holy Son, Christ, bless us in the promise of being in the Holy Son, Christ. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy that with these gifts we pray. By sending down your Spirit upon them like you, so that they may become for all us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he betrayed his willing beings his passion, he took bread and giving thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take it, all of you will eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you.
As one of the campus ministers at the Ursuline School, I am pleased to present these students, as well as some faculty members, who will be commissioned as extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion. Our students, Fiona Galvin, Sophie Hennessy, Maria Lenny, and our faculty and staff, Mrs. Carbone, Mrs. Parisi, and Ms. Pisano. As extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion, they will administer the body and blood of Christ in our all-school liturgies. I would ask them that they now please come forward.
Your kingdom comes, make known to the village by this one family prayer, one of mine and all. bless us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And we go forth into peace.
Thank you. Thank you.